It's airborne. The third one is fuel that vision with perseverance, because it won't be easy. Fuel the vision with perseverance. You see, in all of this you say you want to do, you will see a lot of things coming your way, distracting you, challenging that thing. Your family will not believe in you. Your close friends will distract you. I am a picture. I am one of those people. Everything I wrote here, the things that happened to me. You know my number one fan today? The person who talks most about me today, do you know who he is? My father. But the same man didn't support me when I was starting. When I was starting, he didn't support me. Because he said to me that this thing is not for, first, you're too young for this. Second, you will not reach this. He mentioned the likes of Zebe, Jiro, and Koda, those. And he didn't believe. At some point, he called the younger brother, the last born, who should have won. Encouraged my father, somebody who was educated, or who is educated, he said to him that this boy wants to be useless. And the medical doctor supported him. He didn't believe in it. But I know this, you know, I continued. It was when, you know, women, there's something about women, they have the soft spot. When my mom saw that I was determined, she had no choice, she started supporting me. If I have a shoot, she will bring her money to cook for the gas and grill. That's what she was always doing, because she found that I was bent on this thing. At some point, when my dad saw that, come, this boy is determined, there's nothing. He took me to somebody. I borrowed, I think I needed about 120,000 to round off what I was doing. He took me to a very close friend and borrowed money. They gave me the 120, but the 120 did not complete the job. And he felt disappointed. He sold his shares, gave me the money. They think they complete the job, and the man was disappointed. He said, I told you this thing from the onset. These things will happen. I'm not saying we shouldn't listen to our parents. They have their own idea. Because by the time everything started going wrong, he reminded me that, look, I told you that this thing will not work. Now we have 120,000 items to pay. I have sold my shares, gave you 70,000. Then, oh, this was happening around 2000. I mean, 98, 99. Yeah, 1998, 99. You know what? I continued. But when everything now changed, he's the one who will always come. Once he sees that you're watching TV, he will ask you, do you watch Clinic Matters? If you say yes, the producer is my son. He'll be the first to tell you that the producer is his son. You know, when you succeed, everyone wants to be your friend. Okay? Now, he didn't do all that earlier because of hatred, no. But he looked at his friend. He felt, we can't do this thing. If I had listened to him then, I may not have been where I am today. So for that picture to work out, you must be ready to persevere, because a lot of things will challenge that idea. You say you want to get married, you're telling the people the kind of husband, you're a woman, you're telling the people the kind of husband, they will look at you, now you are married to a person, they will discourage you. Don't believe in them. Say it out and work towards it. Position yourself. You can't be praying and say you want to marry a wealthy man and you don't educate yourself. Lie. You see, that rich man needs a wife who will help to manage the funds, to manage the resources. That's the first thing the man will look at. I don't know if I'm communicating. You must position yourself. You must train yourself. You must go to school. You must package yourself. You must be ready to present yourself in such a way that when the man sees you, he will know that this is the person. Not that you sit at home. You'll be walking up and down with friends who don't have vision. You surround yourself with friends. You see, the problem many ladies have today, oh my God. The problem of so many ladies today, is a problem of the kind of company they keep. It is not that they are not good, it's not that they are not presentable, but the people around them. When you look at the kind of friends, the kind of company they keep, you believe they are all the same thing. You need to check your company. You need to check your company. The same thing with the guys. Check the kind of company you keep. It's important. All right, moving on. The next one is make a plan but be flexible. You cannot say you want to achieve a particular dream and you don't have a plan to achieve that dream. You say you want to marry a woman and you want to marry a good man and you don't have that, you don't have a plan. What is the plan that will take you to that place? What are the things you need to do? There must be a plan to achieve that thing. Not to be working in this area. Change and just. That's why I say be flexible. Because sometimes you have this plan and along the line you find out that this thing doesn't, because it is your plan. If you know that somebody has just told you something that is the truth with regards to that your plan, adjust. So be flexible with your plan. When I started as a filmmaker. My vision was to make movies. I didn't have any plan for television. I made films and he finished making the movies. The best that will happen is they run the advert on TV, directed by Paul Igwe. No cover was coming in for years. But in 2007, somebody in this office, no, not in this office, the other one, somebody brought a young man to me, and that young man is Bobby, the comedian. Bobby was working as R&D's PA, and then he came to me that he wants to make a TV series. He wants me to come and direct the pilot so that he can go to look for sponsors. I have not done a TV series before, but I have an idea of what it will take to make the series. So when he came there, he gave me his budget. I looked at it at this amount that this man wants to spend on this pilot. If we had to add a little sum to it, we'll make a complete season. And I told him, I said, look, if you can increase this amount to this social amount, we'll make a complete season. He said, that this one he wants to do, that it is somebody that wants to sponsor. I said, go and talk to the person. He said, the person will not listen. I said, take me to the person. And then he took me. When we got there, somewhere on the island, the person happens to be the owner of SPG Oil, a woman. Do you know Stella Ojua?
Yes.
You know her, the former aviation minister, happens to be the person. Then, that's how, this is how things work. I was shocked. Then she had not become, she was just a member, she was just a normal politician. And then when I got there, instead of having to tell the woman what we need to do, what we say, Mama, this is my director, he has something to tell you. And I was like, okay. But you know, the office alone, the woman's office alone, is like four times this office. When we're going in to go and see her, you see her talking to British, that is Oyibo. So I just could not disappoint, I just praised on myself. And then I said, well, the buffy came to me, blah, 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 but I think if we do this, do that, it will work. The woman looked at me. You know the first person the woman asked that? The budget there, buffy wanted to spend about 300 and something thousand, sorry, about 500 and something, and I said, if we have 1 million, we will do this thing. Then the first person the woman asked me, have you seen 1 million before? I looked at her. I didn't say yes, I didn't say no. I said, well, madam, I made a movie, What Go Back to Millionaire. That movie had Max Mua, had Nikuri Aminobi, and I did this. I made this movie 2 years ago. The woman went back to the question and asked the simple question, have you seen 1 million before? And I said, madam, I have made movie of over 2 million naira. She said, I will ask you the third time. Have you seen 1 million before in your life? At that point, at that point, I lost it. But the thing is, my reason it was not to react. My reason it was to tell her what I said the last time. Madam, I have shot a movie of over 2 million naira. She looked at me, looked at Bobby. She now smiled. She now pressed the bell. Once pressed the bell, somebody came in. She asked the person to go and get wine. Go and get wine for this young man. Okay. And Bobby just kept quiet. I didn't know that she's a difficult person. Bobby does not know how to handle her. And Bobby did not tell me. But I was already on the hot seat. And I had to defend myself. I know there's something about when you're a director, you feel like you're on top of the world. I just said to myself, the worst that will happen is to push us. I just said that. And then when they brought the wine, I looked at it. They had alcohol. I told people I don't do alcohol. She said, really? You don't do alcohol? I said, yes. See, you don't have a girlfriend.
I know, I'm seeing the man like this.
But in article, my brother said, he's a pastor. Hey, pastor. You. The man asked that, okay, that she give us the money. But you said you have shot a movie of over 2 million. I said, yes. He said, I'm going to pay that money into your account. It is too above brought to here, but you are the one I have business with. If anything goes wrong, she changed her expression. I said, Mama, nothing will go wrong. She said, okay, no problem. Give your account number. Yes, I gave my account number and we left. When we left, as we came back, Bobby was saying to me, oh boy, if you don't say you know before do this thing, no collect this for you. This man, this has a chance for you. Know. I said, okay, now what's man did die? But you know what? You know what was preparing me then? There was hunger in the land. There was hunger. There was, even though I had a shop there, I needed to do something, you know? And then we started. And God being on our side. The first season of the show came out well. How many of us saw Extended Family? That was the show. So, we did season one, this season two, this season three. But after season three, something happened. By the time we did season one, when we came to do our account for the woman, something you gave us 1 million for, we raked it over 4.8 million. With this season two, you gave us the same 1 million, we raked it over 7 million. With this season three, you gave us the same 1 million. And then this time, because the show was becoming bigger and bigger, this time we raked it over 10 million. And I now told the woman that for us to do season four, that we need a raise. We need to raise the fees of all the actors, the crew, everybody. That to make that season, we need 3 million. And the woman said, no. That what she will do is, she will raise my fee, she will raise Bobby's. And I said, no. That if you remember, the first day we came here, Bobby told you that I'm a pastor. I'm not a pastor, but I have some conscience. You cannot raise my fee. And you won't raise that of the actors. They are the people they see. Every time these people tell us that we're making money, they see all the adverts, but we try to calm them down. It will not be fair. You know these worldly people, they have a way of seeing hunger. The woman knows the hunger, they catch us. And then boldly, she said, I will not do anything. I will raise your own. I will raise that for Buffy. She now looked at Buffy and said, Buffy, I think you need a car. You need a car. What I'm telling you is the truth. There's this small car called Q something. Can't remember the name again. One small portable car. You know, what they do in some of these companies, when they go buy like 10 cars, they will give them one free. So that was one of the cars they gave them as. So you might just call someone and say, so car, give that car to Bobby. Bobby needs a car. Just like that. But we were determined. Because before we went there, Bobby and I were determined. So she told us that she wouldn't raise it. I was okay. If you don't raise money, no wahala. We left. Like play. The woman did not raise. And you know, I said something. It was not difficult for me to go back. But guess what? Sometimes things happen in your favor. In the course of shooting season one, season two, season three of that show, remember I said something that I'm talking about being flexible. I mean, that's what I am, being flexible. I was originally a movie producer, not a TV producer. But you see, by the time I had done 1, 2, 3 of that show, I had learned something about television production. So when we didn't go back, I called one of the actors on that show to write a script for me. I created a script, and that was Clinic Matters. The person who wrote it was shot Clinic Matters in 2009. Throughout 2009, it was struggle. Everybody around me thought I was stupid. Everybody thought I was making a mistake because I kept on spending and nothing was coming in. But you know something? 2010, boom. there was an explosion. Within that 2009, if I had listened to people, I would have stopped production. Because it was so bad that I was close to selling my car. I had one car then, and I was close. I was in a BMW then. I was close to selling it because I sold so many things. But 2010, I don't know if you saw this advert, one advert, my lady advert, where Saka slapped the king. Yes. That was the first advert they gave me on the show. As soon as I ran that advert, before you know it, everybody, I made so much money that today, by God's grace, in this area, I have my own house. Wow. All right, so be flexible. And today, I hardly call myself a movie producer. It is now TV, because from there, I started making TV. And by His grace, AMVC is going to be seven. This is the seventh edition. And the last, in all the edition, I think it only was that I didn't get a nomination. You won't see me among all the heavy movies, but the moment they come to TV categories, language content, I will always get nominated, and I won once. Do you understand? I'm going somewhere. I'm still going to tell you why I keep getting that nomination. I will tell you why. Okay, so now we understand what I mean by being flexible. Have a plan, whether you're doing business, whether it is marriage, whether it is school, have a plan. Remember what I said initially, don't let your background deceive you. That is, don't look at where you're coming from. Don't say my father doesn't have this money, this, that, that, that. Background will always deceive a lot of people. When you look at where you're coming from, you won't want to move. Remember I said when I wanted to start this, my father said that this business is for the wealthy. Will not get money, now you go do this thing. But today, except I tell people, nobody will know. Am I communicating? So have a big picture, have a plan towards that picture. All right, the next one is embrace your expertise. That area that you're a specialist, that area, don't do jack of all trades. Do you understand me? The reason many of us have not been able to succeed is that we practice jack of all trades. They need an electrician, I did it. They need a carpenter, I can do it. They need a plumber, I'm a barber. Do you understand me? Don't. However, learn. If somebody calls you to come and do this thing, you know you cannot do it. Just call the person who can do it. It's better you have an agreement with that person who is an expert. Look, I have a plumbing job. I am not a plumber. I want you to go and do the job. But whatever you get, I have 10%, I have 20%. Let that person go and do it. Am I communicating? You see, there's something we don't understand. The people you want to do business with are watching, they are smart. They call you, you say you do this, you do that, you do that. Instantly, they know that you're a jack of all trades, they will give business to you. I told us I started as a movie maker, but by the time I started doing TV, I stopped everything moving. And that's why till date, very recently I started making movies for television, but till date, people now refer to me as a TV producer. Last year, I was on my own, JJO, back of industry, did a research, looking for top 10 TV producers that they want to finance their projects. I was just saying, somebody brought a letter from Bank of Industry, gave us a date for the meeting. When we got there, we found out that we were about 12 of us. Myself, the producer of Dear Mother, all the top producers, all the top TV producers, we just got there, we saw ourselves. And we were like, what's going on? Before the MD9 came out to address us, that they did their research, that they have been financing cinema production, all these movies you see in the cinema, not even are financed by the Bank of Industry. So now they want to go into TV, but they want to start with people whose business is TV production. They didn't go to ask questions, they simply went online, did their research, because if you're a TV producer, you always have your presence online. And that was how, and guess what? Everybody they brought there was a TV producer, there was no film producer. But over the years, when I started doing well in TV, people would come to me and say they want me to come and direct their movie. I don't direct, I refer them to movie directors. Even though I started out as a movie director, but I will refer them. It was until, I think, 2 years ago, when I saw that the TV business was going, and I said, okay, cinema is becoming interesting. Let me try it. And I started directing cinema. But even at that, I still do not major in that area. Am I communicating? That's why I have not been distracted. It's when you do this, you do that one, you do this, you do, you will be distracted. But when you concentrate on one, you will grow and become a champion. By God's grace, I am a champion in TV production. I am recognized in Nigeria and outside of this country as a TV producer. I have won an award as a TV producer in Fire Away from France. Okay? Not award by blacks, even by whites. Do you understand?
Yeah.
So in every area, in everything you're doing, make sure you're an expert. Make sure you're an expert in what you're doing. Alright. Now, the next one is, don't reinvent the wheel. Do not reinvent the wheel. What do I mean? Which example do I need most now? Okay, let me use a common example. I think this one will fly. Have you seen people? Somebody comes now and says he needs a computer that is very, very fast. That is so speed. You see somebody will come and say, don't worry, I'll configure it, I'll do it for you. I'll buy this, I'll buy that, I'll put them together. Meanwhile, that person is just somebody who just learned computer engineering. Have you noticed that all those things that they put together, no matter how they do them, it cannot be fast like when you go to the market and buy the one that was produced from the company. Have you noticed that?
Yes.
Yeah, maybe you've not observed.
Yes, sir.
What am I trying to say? Many of us, when you come, you see that this is how they do things here. Everybody has been doing this thing this way. You will now come, you want to reinvent it. No, it will fail. Rather, what you do is you improve. What do I mean? When I was starting Clinic Matters, I saw that everybody had drama. Drama, comedy drama, everything. I said to myself, okay, what can I do that will look different? Am I communicating? I simply did something. I watched the foreign comedy, all this Hollywood comedy. When you watch them, you see that they talk fast. Have you noticed? What I simply did was to make my actors, those girls, nurses, I made them talk too much, but they talk very fast. That is, they don't think. If you watch Clinic Matters, you notice that when Abigail and Biniki are arguing, this one wants to defeat it. It is coming bam bam bam. The reason people love Clinic Matters is because of the way the actors act. Nothing. There's nothing special about Clinic Matters. I am the producer. There's nothing special. The only thing is that on the actors, I force them to deliver. So when you see them, have you seen ladies gossip before? Gossip, you know, they slow.
I tell
you this. No. Two of us. Jack, you see that when you're gossiping, you don't think about it, you don't say it slowly. I see getting there. Hey, Chama. Guess what I saw now? I saw it. It was blah, blah, blah. That's how gossip. Two of us. So that was the reason I brought into Clinic Matters. That was just the magic in Clinic Matters. I made sure that when they want to gossip, it is hot. That was the only magic. I didn't go to say, okay, let me change this thing, let me change it, let me do this. No, if I had done it, it would have failed. I simply improved on what they're doing. So where am I going? Don't try to, whatever business or whatever thing you're trying to do, don't try to change what is already working. Rather, work on improving it. If you work on improving it, you'll find out that you do it better. Am I communicating?
Yes.
Alright. The next one is set ambitious goals. ambitious goals. I said that by the time I was 19, when I said that when I'm 40, I will not work again. Yet, my papa no be Dangote. I didn't look at none of them. But I said that when I'm 40, I will not work again. Somebody was saying that you know, that's a goal.
Yes.
I need to work towards achieving it. Now, guess what? In trying to achieve this thing, it wasn't as if every day I would say, 40 is coming closer. I simply said to myself, I want to achieve this, and I was working to become okay. It was when I became 40 that it occurred to me that you said, when you are 40, maybe if I, you know, said, 40 is coming close, let me, I would have lost the track. I would have left the path. Am I communicating? But because I want to be a better person, I want to come out to, I just hate poverty. And before you know it, I achieved something at 40. You must have a goal. I don't know about you. Have you set to yourself, this is what I want to achieve in 5 years' time? If you don't have a goal about what you want to achieve, you will not achieve anything. Whether you're a student, whether you're a businessman, no matter, you must have a goal. It is that goal that will push you. Your business will be to check if you're meeting up. Everything I tell you are the things I have tried. I said I was going to tell you my story. I'm practically telling you my story. That's what I've been doing, just telling you my story. All right, now, focus on the process. To achieve this goal, there must be a process towards achieving it. Focus on that process. You have a process to achieve this thing. You come to seminars like this, you listen to what people are saying, you go back and check this thing that I'm doing, what am I not doing right? There is a process. Just keep focused. Compare what you're doing, because when you share experiences, you know, when you listen to others who have gone through that route, you will know what to do, you will know how to improve. You need to hear. I listen a lot. I don't take people for granted, no. I don't, because that person you think has nothing to offer will give you an idea. I'm telling us, that person you think is stupid will say something that will take